Custom properties introduce a new level of configuration and customization to CSS, and being able to hook into and manipulate these custom properties using JavaScript opens up a whole new dimension of possibilities. In this example, I've used custom properties to set the color and background color of each of the link items. You'll notice here I'm setting up the color to use the custom property color, and then there's a fallback value, black, if we don't have color defined. And the same thing for background color. There's a variable or a custom property called bgColor, and then a fallback called for transparent if there is no custom property defined. I'm using these fallbacks because in the main style sheet, there is no custom properties defined. These two colors here, the color and background color, are never defined. There are some other custom properties defined at the very top. If you go look, we have max width and white space, but there's no color and no BG color. This is one example of how we can use custom properties to do really advanced styling for individual items. Because although color and BG color are not defined in the style sheet, they are defined in line on one of the elements. You can see it here. We have the element, then a style attribute, and then we have color and BG color defined. And as a result, these custom properties kick in for this one element here. So that means we can define how the styling is going to happen in our style sheet and then use custom properties only where necessary in line in the elements themselves, which is really cool. And you can see how this could easily be extended using JavaScript by injecting custom property values into elements when needed. So this begs the obvious question, how do we access custom properties using JavaScript? The answer is the same way we've been doing it so far. So here's an example of how to access the inline custom properties for that element. We first go grab the element itself, and then we say console log list item, so the element, style, and then use get property value and call for the property value. Run this in the browser, and you see in the console, we have the value for that property. And this is the value of the custom property defined in line. You can go back and look at it. It's this value right here. You'll also notice I'm using get property value here because the custom property name starts with two dashes. And as we've now learned, two dashes as a JavaScript property name does not work. If we try to say list item style dot dash dash color, it simply wouldn't work. It would be a syntax error. So here we have to use get property value. It also means we can't do some of this traversing that we've been doing previously because the custom properties are just different. So that's inline styles, and it makes sense. What about style sheets? You'll remember in my style sheet, I've defined some custom properties here at the very top. So this is the first rule. And that means if I go and say document style sheets 0, I get the first style sheet. Then I can go in and grab the CSS rules on the first element from that. So I'll say console log style sheet. That gives me the current style sheet. And then I'll say CSS rules. And here I want the first rule, so that has index number 0. And then I want to know about the custom properties. So here I have max width and white space. So let's say style get property value and dash dash max width, save, back in the browser, 70VW. And that's really all there is to it. Custom properties behave exactly the same way as any other CSS property. The only thing you need to keep in mind is that there are no JavaScriptified property names for these. So these camel case property names, because the custom properties always start with dash dash. So here you have to use get property value to get at the property value.